Philippine shares are off to a strong start to the new trading year in anticipation of higher corporate earnings and economic growth. Michelle Ong reports.
The MSCI Asia-Pac Index starting the year on the back foot with its first decline in 7 days, dragged by China stocks, hammered by weaker-than-expected factory data, and a rare admission by President Xi Jinping of weakness in the world's number two economy. The Hang Seng Index dropping as much as 1.9%. Here at home, Philippine shares outperformed Asian peers on the first trading day of the year amid expanding factory activity, albeit at a slower pace. For the day, the PSE Index supercharged back above 6550 after gaining 1.6%, supported by nearly 450 million pesos worth of net foreign buying.
We are expecting earnings still at around 9-10%. And then, of course, GDP will be growing faster. So it's really a question of how fast the Fed will bring rates down. People are projecting 2 to 3 rate cuts. I'm sure that the BSP will also follow or work in tandem. And that should be good for the economy. People are shifting already. They're taking their gains on their fixed income, as you said, and then they'll now shift to equities.
In corporate stories, the BPI-Robinsons Bank merger, first announced in 2022, has finally taken effect January 1st. BPI, the surviving entity, earlier said the merger will lead to various synergies across products, platforms, and customer base, particularly the Filipino-Chinese market, as well as help facilitate collaboration across the Gokongwei Group's ecosystem. The Gokongweis now collectively own approximately 6% of the resulting outstanding capital stock of BPI, the country's fourth largest bank. In other news, Global Fair Nickel Holdings, the Philippines' second-largest nickel ore producer, says its subsidiaries, Platinum Group Metals and Ipila Nickel Corporation, have signed an annual sale and purchase agreement with Bao Steel Resources International. Under the agreement, Bao Steel would purchase up to 1.5 million wet metric tons of nickel ore for the year at a price that's determined monthly based on the prevailing market price. For context, Global Fair Nickel shipped 4.763 million wet metric tons in 2023, with 0.379 million wet metric tons sold to Bao Steel. Michelle Ong, ABS-CBN News.